I mean, Mr. Srivastav, let me first begin with you. I think one of the problems with this whole thing has been the fact that on the one hand, India wants to have close relations with Iran, and on the other hand, since it's very close to the United States and the U.S. has got Iran under primary and secondary sanctions, so Delhi doesn't really understand or figure out how to go about this.
In fact, India has been doing this kind of balancing act with the neighbor, a near neighbor in geopolitical area, Iran, for last almost two decades. If you recall that, because of U.S. sanctions, India was not able to proceed with Iran for quite some time, even for procurement of crude oil also, which is an essential need for India. And this Chabahar project was a 628-kilometer pipeline, which was giving a way from Chabahar to Zahandan in Afghanistan, was a big, advantage for India for meeting the requirements of Afghanistan and bypassing its, troubling neighbor, the Pakistan, and they were able to even send a supply sometimes in 2016 to Chabahar port. In Chabahar port, they were allowed two terminals and five berths over there to do it. But I feel that this is a big setback to India's diplomatic relationships with Iran, for that matter, and losing that particular project altogether. And the second blow which has come is now that Iran, they were about to develop a field in Farzad B, where India's oil companies, Indian Oil Corporation, Oil India Limited, and ONGC had shown tremendous progress, and it would have been a big gain for India, for that matter. Even that project also has been dropped by Iran, and Iran has decided to develop it on its own, and they are entering into an agreement with China, and they're going to have almost a 10-year lease with them for $400 billion a gas project. So I think that India has to re-